Hi everyone, this is Kavya here, going to explain the topic price determination in perfect and imperfect competition. First of all, what is market? Market is a place where buying and selling of goods and services takes place. It is a place where producers will be selling their products and the consumers will be buying the products. Market is classified on the basis of three factors, that is time, area and competition. On the basis of time, it is of very short period and long period. On the basis of area, it is local market, national market and international market. On the basis of competition, now which we are going to discuss here, it is perfect competition and imperfect competition. What is perfect competition market and imperfect competition market? Perfect competition market is a market where there are large number of buyers and sellers, and no one buyer or seller can determine the price of a commodity, and all the buyers and the sellers would be selling the products which are homogeneous, that is all must be similar in the both quality and quantity. All the products must be similar, that is called as homogeneous product. Now going into the price determination, as we know that there are large number of buyers and sellers, and no one buyer or no one seller can determine the price. Here in perfect competition market, the average revenue, marginal revenue and the price are same. As you can see here, this is your output: price, total revenue, average revenue and marginal revenue. Here your output is 1, like it's be increasing from 1 to 6. Your price would be the same. In perfect competition, there would be no change in price. The price would be same. Here you'll be calculating your total revenue, average revenue and marginal revenue. Total revenue is calculated by multiplying your price and output. That is 1 into 10, 10, 2 into 10, 20 and so on till 60. Average revenue is the total revenue per output. That means total revenue by output, that is 10 by 1, that is 10, 20 by 2, that is 10, average revenue will be 10, 10, 10, so on. Now marginal revenue. Marginal revenue is the additional revenue. Marginal revenue is the additional revenue which is made to the total revenue, which is made to the total revenue with the addition of one more output. Here 10 is 10, 20 minus 10 is 10, 30 minus 10 and so on, it will be 10 again. Here, if this box is depicted in a way of graph, then the graph would be like this. Then your graph would be like this. That box is depicted here like this. Then the graph would be in a straight line which is parallel to the x-axis. Here the straight line depicts your average revenue, marginal revenue and the price. This is for the case of perfect competition. Market brings a balance between what is brought to sale and what is demanded. That is your, like, here you will be knowing how you'll be getting the equilibrium. Like the price is determined by the forces of your demand curve and supply. Here this is your price, this is your supply and this is your demand. We know that the price and demand have an inverse relationship. That means when price increases, there will be a decrease in the demand, and when price decreases, there will be an increase in the demand. Here you can observe that when the price is increased from 1 to 5, then your quantity demanded will be decreasing from 60 to 20. And other thing is, there is a positive or a direct relationship between price and supply. That is, when your price is increasing, your supply also increases. When your price decreases, your supply also increases. Here you can see that when your price is increasing from 1 to 5, your supply also increases from 20 to 60. If this box is depicted in the form of a graph, then you will be having the graph in such a way. This would be a graph if that box is depicted in the type of a graph. So this is your demand curve and this is your supply curve. The demand curve is downward sloping and your supply curve is upward sloping. When where the demand and supply curves meet, that is your equilibrium point. At the equilibrium point, whichever price is there, that would be your equilibrium price. And at the equilibrium point, whatever output is there, that would be your equilibrium output. So this is the condition of equilibrium. Now, equilibrium of firm. When the firm is in equilibrium, like means any firm who wants maximum profits will always choose an output that will be giving him maximum profits. Any firm which is in equilibrium does not have any desire to change its output, because at the output he will be getting his maximum profits. So no firm would be interested to increase or decrease its output at the equilibrium point. At the equilibrium point, the equilibrium is of two, that is short run equilibrium and long run equilibrium. In short run, the fixed factors cannot be changed. So there is the only way to increase the output is by increasing your variable factors. In short run, you may have supernormal profits, normal profits and losses. The conditions which are necessary for the equilibrium of a firm are, first one, the your marginal cost curve must equal your marginal revenue curve. And the second condition is, the marginal cost curve must cut your marginal revenue curve from below. Industry will be at equilibrium at a certain price, and that price which is determined by the industry is passed over to the firm. Here you can see this is the industry which is the price giver, and that would be your firm which is your price taker. Here the demand of the industry and the supply of the industry are meeting at a point which is the equilibrium point of the industry. So the price at the equilibrium point would be your equilibrium price. So that price which is determined by the industry is carried forward to the firm. So the firm will be taking that price and will be continuing its output. As I said that in short run, we'll be having supernormal profits, normal profits and losses. First, we'll be discussing about each one slowly. The first one is supernormal profits, where this is your average revenue curve and marginal revenue curve and price. As I said that in perfect competition, your average revenue curve, marginal revenue curve and your price are the same. Here, this is your MC curve and this is your AC curve. In the previous chapters, we have learned that the AC curve and MC curves are in U shape. So here you can see that they both are in U shapes. This is your MC and this is your AC. Now, the condition of equilibrium is where the MC curve is equals to MR curve and the MC curve cuts MR curve from below. That is your equilibrium point. That is, this MC curve is equaling MR curve here and it's cutting from below. So this point is the equilibrium point. The price at equilibrium point is equilibrium price and the output is equilibrium output, same. So at the equilibrium point, you have to check that whether you have got the equilibrium. Now you have to check that whether the firm is running in normal profits, super normal profits or losses. So for that, you have to compare your average cost curves and your average revenue curve. Here, your average cost curve is this. This one, and your average revenue curve is this one. So at the equilibrium point, your average revenue is this and average cost is this. That means here I'm showing that the revenue is more. That means whatever you're getting is more, and whatever you're spending, that is cost of production, average cost is less. Here your revenue is more and your average cost is less, so that it is the condition of supernormal profits. The shaded part here represents your supernormal profits. So the next case is about losses. Here you can see that the same thing again repeats. This is your price, average revenue and marginal revenue curves. This is MC curve, AC curve. Here the MC equals MR at this point. That is your equilibrium point. At the equilibrium point, your average cost is more than your average revenue. That means the cost which you are incurring, you are spending on that, or you are incurring is more, and revenue which you are getting in return is less. So this is the condition of losses, where you are spending more and getting less. So the shaded part here represents the losses of the firm. Now we are going to learn about normal profits. This is the condition where your revenue and cost both are equal. here this is your price and average revenue and marginal revenue, where the MC curve equals your MR curve, that is your equilibrium point. So this would be your equilibrium point. At the equilibrium point, the average revenue equals your average cost. That means your revenue is equal to your cost. So what you are spending, you are getting in return. So there is no profit, no gain. So that is the that is the concept of normal profits. Now we have done with the short run equilibrium, where we have learned about supernormal profits, normal profits and losses. Now we are going to long run. Now we are going to long run equilibrium. In short run, the output can be adjusted to a certain extent by increasing your variable factors or decreasing your variable factors. But in long run, the output can be adjusted to any extent, as all the factors are variable. Any factor of production is variable in long run. But in long run, we won't be having supernormal profits or losses. We'll be only having normal profits. That is why now we are here, we want to discuss. We are not going to have supernormal profits, because due to supernormal profits, like, the firms get attracted due to the supernormal profits and they enter into the industry. So with the entry of new firms, the supernormal profits gets wiped out. So like that, you'll be losing your supernormal profits. You won't be having supernormal profits. Then what about losses? If the firm is having losses, then because of the losses, the output which is there would be left without produce. So the firm would be reducing its supply. If the firm is reducing its supply, then you'll be then the firm will be getting a new supply curve, that is from S to S dash. If there's a new supply curve, then there'll be new meeting point between the demand and the supply of, that means the new supply curve which we have, which is changed. So this is the point where you'll be attaining new equilibrium. So at the new equilibrium point, you'll be having a new price, which is OP bar, OP dash, and there'll be a new output, which is OQ dash. So that new price now will be carried to the firm here. Before, as we have seen the losses condition, if you don't see this is the new price, then this part would be your losses. And then AC curve would be here and AR curve would be here in the case of losses. Now, due to there's a new price, because of the reduce in supply, the new price will be carried to the firm. So this OP bar, OP dash would be your new supply. So when you're drawing it in the graph, then that point, your AC curve and your AR curve will meet, so that the losses turn out to be normal profits due to the increase in price with the help of a reduce in the supply. So here we have known why there will be no supernormal profits or losses in the long run. So in the long run, your average revenue curve, average cost curve, and your marginal revenue curve and marginal cost curve all would be equal in long run. So that is the case. We have completed our price determination in perfect competition. Next topic we are going is price determination in imperfect competition. In imperfect competition, the AR curve and MR curve are different. It is not the same, like the both are not the same as in perfect competition. Here, this is your output, this is your price. In imperfect competition, the price can be say, like the price is different for the same product. So there will be a change in price here. There will be 10, 9, 8, the price is decreasing. The price may increase or decrease, but here in the example, we are taking it as decreasing one. This is the total revenue, average revenue and marginal revenue. Total revenue can be calculated by multiplying your price and output. 10 into 1, 10, 2 into 9, 18, 3 into 8, 24, like that it will be going on till 32. Now average revenue. Average revenue is the total revenue per unit output. Per unit output, that is total revenue by output. That is 10 by 1 is 10, 18 by 2 is 9. So that your average revenue will be decreasing from 10 to 5. The next is the marginal revenue. Marginal revenue is the addition made to the total revenue with the addition of one more output. there is an addition of 8 units while adding one more unit here. So the marginal revenue would be 8, like 10, 8, 6, 4, 2 and 0. The marginal revenue here in this box, you can see that the marginal revenue is decreasing at a faster rate than the average revenue. If the before box is depicted in a form of a diagram, then it would be like in the form of a graph, it would be like this. That is, this is your AR curve and this is your MR curve. Here, MR curve would be like reducing at a faster rate, so it would be slightly bigger than the AR curve. In the imperfect competition, the monopolist will have the complete control over the supply of the commodity. He is also the price maker. He can fix any price on his own to get maximum profits. The monopolist either he can't do both things simultaneously. That means both fixation of the price and the quantity. He can do either one or leave other to the consumer. That is, either he can fix the price of the commodity and leave the quantity to be determined by the consumer demand, and or he could fix the output and he could leave the price to be determined for the commodity on the basis of consumer demand. Like either he can fix the price or the output, but he can't do both at a time. In imperfect competition, both the industry and firm are same. The conditions required to obtain or to acquire equilibrium are same as in the perfect competition. That is, the first one is MC curve must equal your MR curve, and the second one is the MC curve must cut your MR curve from below. Here, in imperfect competition, the firm is in equilibrium when your MC curve equals your MR curve. Here also, in imperfect competition also, we have three cases. That is supernormal profits, normal profits and losses. The first one is normal profits. The monopolist will keep on increasing his output until his MR exceeds MC. That is, until his marginal revenue exceeds marginal cost, as it is profitable for him. Because the revenue which is getting is more than the cost which is incurring or spending. So this is the case of supernormal profits. Here you can see that this is your AR curve and this is your MR curve. As I said that MR curve in imperfect competition, the marginal revenue curve will be slightly faster decreasing. So the MR curve would be touching the x-axis here. The equilibrium conditions are the MC, the marginal cost curve must cut marginal revenue curve from below. This is the point where MC curve equals your MR curve and it is cutting the MR curve from downward. So this is the point where the firm is in equilibrium. Now we have to check that whether it is in supernormal, it is in normal profits, supernormal profits or losses. So we must compare the average cost curves and average revenue curves. Here at this point, this is your average cost. That is, average cost is the cost of production that is spent. So this is the cost which is incurred and this is the revenue which we got. So from here we can say that the cost which is incurred is less and the revenue which we have got is more. So that is the case of supernormal profits. So the shaded part here represents the supernormal profits in imperfect competition. So the next case we're going to learn about losses. Here is the condition of losses. This is the average revenue curve. This is your marginal revenue curve. That is the same for everything. In imperfect competition, the condition also the same. That is, the MC curve must cut MR curve from below and must equal MR curve. Here is the point where MC equals MR and it is cutting MR from below. So at this point, at that equilibrium point, the average cost is this much and the average revenue is this much. That shows that here the average cost is more than your average revenue. That is, the cost which you are incurring or spending is more, the value you are getting in return. So this is the condition of losses where your cost is more than revenue. The shaded part here represents the losses of the firm. The next part is normal profits. This is the condition of normal profits in imperfect competition. This is your average revenue curve and this is your marginal revenue curve, where the MC curve cuts MR curve from below, and where MC curve equals your MR curve, that is your equilibrium point, that is the point here where MC equals MR and it's cutting from below. At the equilibrium point, the average revenue and average cost both are same. That means what you're incurring or what you're spending is same as what you're getting in back. That means the cost and revenue are equal. So this is the case of normal profits. If the monopolist will stop his output at the short of an output, then he'll be unnecessarily foregoing some of the profits which he could. So he must be at an equilibrium point at a output OQ. If he increases the output more than OQ, then he will be incurring losses. If he is reducing his output less than OQ, then he will be unnecessarily leaving some of the profits. So the entrepreneur must choose such an output where he will be getting the maximum profits, that is at the equilibrium point. With this, we have completed our topic, price determination in imperfect competition. Hope you understood, and thank you everyone.